Hey guys, what's up? I'm going to do my review now on the Pride mode in UFC Undisputed 3. I promised this in my last video. Sorry it didn't come out any sooner. I'm doing what I can over here. In my previous video, I reviewed the UFC side of the game. This is still just the demo. The game actually releases in full on February 14th, and I just pre-ordered mine. You should probably go do the same and fight me, I guess, when it is released. So that'd be kind of cool. A lot of you haters I know would like to fight me, and this is probably your only chance. Let's see. If you don't know what Pride is, it was the biggest MMA organization in the world. It ran from 1997 to 2007, where it was bought by Zuffa, the owners of the UFC. Most of Pride was always fought in Japan. There was a couple in the States actually towards the end of the career. And in between, I'm not too sure. I don't think so. But a lot of the fighters you probably know, such as Vanderlei Silva and Rampage Jackson, also Dan Henderson, Alistair Overeem, the list goes on and on and on. These were all guys that fought in Pride and were transferred over to the UFC. Most of the fighters were transferred to the UFC when they were bought in 2007. There are some differences. Obviously, the match length, which is one of the first things you'll probably notice. The first round is always 10 minutes. The second two rounds are 5 minutes. The weight classes were a little different as well. The fights were fought in a ring, not in a cage or an octagon like in the UFC. Like I said, the weight classes were different. The middleweight was 205 pounds, which in the UFC, the 205 pound weight division is called light heavyweight. So there were many little small differences, I guess you could say. The fighter entrances were a lot more epic as well. There's lots of people coming out with dancers and all sorts of crazy stuff, wearing masks and weird costumes, and the list goes on and on and on. Also, the ref always had a ref cam on his head for the most part. So it's kind of cool. You got to see replays from the ref's point of view, who is in there with the fighter, so that's kind of cool. Also, a lot of the rules were a little different in that you could kick someone while they're down in the head. Soccer kicking was allowed, but things like headbutting and biting and all that stuff were still illegal. Another thing to stop stalling and fighting I know in a lot of fights you see, not in a lot, but in some fights you see people kind of stalling and trying to win on points and whatever, trying to win a judge's decision, right? In Pride, they had a thing called a yellow card, which they would issue if they felt you were stalling or not producing enough action on the feet or on the ground, and that would actually eventually deduct a percentage of your pay. So a lot of the fights were a little more fast-paced than you see in the UFC. Actually, that's not true. There's tons of good fights in the UFC. I'm just trying to make an example here. What else was different? One of the biggest differences was the crowd. I know in a lot of other MMA organizations, I'll just say the UFC to make the comparison, you see the fans cheering and screaming and jumping up and down and spilling their beer on themselves. In Japan, all of the fans were seated. They would clap and go ooh and ah. It was a completely different atmosphere, and if you guys don't understand what I'm talking about, you should probably watch a Pride fight or watch a Pride event, or go buy the DVDs somewhere if you can. So there are many different things like that. It was also fought in a ring. I don't know if I said that already. It's pretty obvious anyway. And if you haven't watched my last video, and I don't blame you if you haven't, I talked about the gameplay and what I thought of it compared to the previous games. You should probably go watch that video. I talk a little more about it. But anyway, I'll just go through it quick. It's a lot more smooth. The transitions on the ground are much, much better. If you do get knocked down, you can sway your character to move out of the way of strikes, and that actually gives you a way better chance at survival, and I found myself coming back in fights after getting knocked down because of that. So that's awesome. There's also icons in the top left and top right of the screen, which show you how much damage you're taking and where you're taking the damage, and that can actually make you change your strategy midway through a fight, which is kind of cool too. So that's a really nice improvement. And when you are hitting someone, you're actually hitting them in the head. I know in the previous games there was a lot of missing and it just didn't make sense. But anyway, also at the end of the fights, there is a sheet that comes up, screen that comes up, I guess. It shows you all the stats in the fight, punches thrown, landed. So that's really cool. And but anyway, hope you guys like my review. I'll come out with some more of these when the game is released. And please leave a like and subscribe maybe, and I'll talk to you guys later.